Beanoblack, folks, and basically there will be thanks out to this guy and everything like that as soon as we know. I don't take time to go into this footage here. And basically, I don't think it's DA. This is going to be the closest object by us in February 13th through the 16th. It's just, when is it going to get here? Now, this is moving too fast, as you can see with your own eyes. There's Earth, and the sun's over there. Okay. Now, they did turn the satellite, as you've seen in my videos, to take a look. Okay. Now, if what we turned and looked at, and this is the normal map that we always show you for, and basically that's what we should see for planets and so forth and so on. Okay. We always tell you the angles. It's always got to be pay attention to the angles, the height, the level, because basically all this stuff is not just sitting on a plate, and everything's got a little bit different orbit around the sun, okay? Not completely flat, and we rifle around the sun, okay? So this little right that you're seeing there, it is coming. It's a forerunner, I think, because it's moving so fast. Either that or the closing speed of DA-14, the JPL cannot track how fast it's going. I mean, they do. They know exactly how fast it's going. It might be changing. They're all of a sudden looking at it because it's like it's closing very fast, as you can see. Okay? In just 3 days' time, that did that. Okay? That's 3 days' time. Okay? So, with that being Earth up to the left, which is basically Earth is right here, the angle is going to be pretty close. Now, everything that comes in like this, the comets, they come in and go around the sun. Okay? So this should be pretty much realistic footage and everything like that, because he does have the SOHO window here and getting this and going and getting the movie up. I've got to start knowing what to type in to be able to pull this up, because this is the footage that I keep on getting hid from me when I go to Sechi, which you should be able to get everything at Sechi, but this guy figured out how to get in there and get that information. Now, like, once again, I don't really kind of think that it's DA-12, but the thing is, you can flip a coin. It could be, it couldn't be. No matter what, 2012 DA-14 is not supposed to get here till the 16th, and I got the probabilities of it hitting. It's going to be 16,000 miles, pretty much roughly. And we're going to have basically the data on it here, and it'll save me even doing that. So basically, he's got standard YouTube, and I just basically went in there and took this footage. It's not stealing anything, it's just the same thing. If I'm going to go to JPL, it's going to have the same action and everything like that. And I will, eventually, because we'll be keeping an eye on this. My footage, if you go to my video, and I'll have to actually, because I make so many videos, sitting at 500 now. And basically, remember, the tickers lie because they always lie and try to hide the truth about a lot of stuff. Basically, there'll be a video that I should upload before this one that's going to be telling you a little bit about my life and the idea that the power is always got that power. So, but then since I got my intangible, I got some power too. So, and I love every branch of the U.S. military. So anyway, we have this coming along here. And that's our object. That's our object, and it's coming at us. Okay? That is Earth up here. That is the object down here, and this is Earth here, and the sun's way over here. Now we need to find out if it's just, that could be just going, like another comet going to the sun. And that's what I do believe. The proportional integral derivatives and the odds makers in Vegas, hello, I love you guys. So anyway, they are very good at proportional integral derivatives too, and we just need to know how kind of distance separation that we have between Earth here and that object, okay? Because it does look to be far away and not going to be bothering Earth at all. Magnetical earthquakes and so forth and so on, we've already showed you scientifically and everything that basically in Earth, Mother Nature, and the volcanoes and earthquakes every day are proving you that. So there's your object, and this is all the footage that you get from that on the 5th, okay? And then also pay attention to my videos, and I'm going to be also making, and I'll try to get some footage in here on that today of what we've got going on. So my answer right now, I figure it's a forerunner to our DA-14 that's going to be here. Now, a scientist at NASA said the 13th, okay, February 13th. Okay, 14th, you know that's Valentine's Day. It doesn't really matter. But he was saying 13 days, the 13th, so it could be 3 days early. So if it's 3 days early, then there's a lot of adjustment. They're not very sure on how fast it's moving. Now, I don't think, once again, I think this is a comet that's headed to the sun. It's a big comet. We may get way more than one. They really know that DA14 is going to be really bright. Is this it? This could be it, as it's going to be, that we're catching it early. It's going to go around the other side of the sun, come back out around behind us or in front of us, and then we'll be watching JPL. I'll be taking you to the player and stuff, and we'll be keeping an eye on this stuff. So let's go ahead and see what we've got fresh from SETI. And as much as I was watching it last year and everything, the world, end of the world is not coming, okay? So don't let the government or anything fool you into that, okay? Don't let any of, but no matter what, you got to watch the New Madrid. You're probably going to have, eventually, over the years or months or weeks or hours or days, something's going to happen, because as you can see, we've got a lot of earthquake activity, and they've been, pay attention to the Navy flood map no matter what over time, but no one, and but I would say it's many years, just the data of how much sea rise within so many years and everything like that. So everybody's getting flying off the hook on that. But New Madrid, you do see all of our basically earthquake activity that is going on. So basically pay attention to that all the time. Always keep up to what's the most active. And when you feel shaken, don't let anything fall on you. Okay? That's pretty much simple. Open ground. And then an open ground, you don't want to be on open ground during a tornado. Okay? Now, we may have this opening forerunning comet right here, possibly. That could be it. And we also have Antares, which is a star, and it's pretty much starting to look more like it is a star. And this is from the latest from LASCO today. And basically, we'll zoom in on this real fast and get a look at this. So we may, like I'm saying, basically just have a comet here that's, because it's moving hella fast. It is large, hell of a large. So the idea that what they've been telling us about DA14, and everybody having it intermingled with it. But then I may be, we're going to have to end up seeing what we've got for looking back at the, because this is basically a head, okay? This is a head satellite. So I got to look at what we have. We could end up being fooled with Antares getting mixed up with, at the current time of, and that may not be the case because this is Venus and Mercury by odds, that basically this should be Venus and Mercury as I go ahead and go to our map right here, okay? So since we're at a head, that should be, and then let's see what we've got here. And I'll also be able to play a movie on this here. The sun's CME in here, and that's what the head shot should look like. So at angles, and this is zoomed in, so what are we getting? We're getting cross information here. And here's what we got. Basically, I'll keep hitting the play. And that's what we've got from the sun. And on stereo ahead, H12. So basically, there's a shot of what should be. So when I'm at the Navy shot, we have to keep in mind that the other stuff that we're seeing, you always got to watch distance and separation, okay? This is a way back shot, and this stuff is way closer. So right now, Venus looks very large, okay? But it is, as you can see the magnetical lines, as I hit play, you can see that we have something right there that doesn't have a magnetical line. It sure doesn't look like it has a magnetical line. As I hit play, you can see the magneticals. So this is Mercury, more than likely, and this is Venus. And Venus looks large because it's very close to the camera, as you see. But also, we have something very interesting between there, and then we had the satellite turn around and look at this stuff. So basically, we may have our object right there that is coming in, and from some direction, we got something. Because no matter what, so we got a lot of great footage we're getting, and we always got to keep separation. But no matter what, this is Venus, and that's Mercury, and then what the hell is that? Alright, so either, no matter what, there's planets out there that we've known that's there, no matter what. NASA needs to start being honest with us about it. Close up on the sun, and it was picking up a little bit last night when I was on, so anyway. Still okay, and tons of stuff up there by it. This stuff is bigger than Jupiter, remember that. All this stuff is bigger than Jupiter, okay? Remember, it's always angles and location, and it always takes a while to decipher what's going on, because you got to be all the distance, okay, and the angle. So always concentrate on that, on stuff. And let's show a little footage here real fast. Maybe this will have something in it. If not, and I kind of doubt it, because remember, this is red colored and it's always layered. So the idea that we get the activity that's up off the sun and everything like that. You know the shot I'm at and everything like that. So I'll just go up a little bit. So sun is flaring still. Don't worry about it. The sun ain't going to go to sleep. Remember, we do need some flaring. Otherwise, we don't have magnetical. Okay. Or it would start to die off quite a bit. So it's always nice to see the sun flare. Okay. So let's see what else we got. Now, these are basically colored over of the black and whites that I show you from Navy. Okay. And then they turn it around also. Okay. So we got to realize everything that's in there. And then we don't have the arm on the Navy sometimes. Okay. And then that what we have up here is, you can see, we don't, so we basically still have what we think to be antennas right here, okay? So, we got to watch that as being antennas as far as we know, okay? This is a head, okay? Either that, or we basically just have Mercury, because as you see, we only have one object and we don't have Venus in this shot, okay? So, and you can see the footage in the time, okay? So, anyway, fresh on Navy. Navy never hides nothing. Now, Navy never hides nothing from us, so this being Mercury and Venus, and then also what we've seen in Antares, then we got to start separating and start figuring stuff out for the actual fact that we do know that when we look at our footage, that we are going to have to start watching for what we know that must be in between here of Venus and Mercury, if in fact this is actually Venus and Mercury there for damn sure, okay? Which Venus and Mercury at this shot should be smaller, okay? They shouldn't be that large, okay? So, i.e., correct, you see? So this is a zoom out. So this is not, can't actually nail that down as that Venus and Mercury, but no matter what, when I show you the movie from here, from H1 ahead to, you basically know, and I can't make it any larger, that there's something between Venus and Mercury right now, okay? And you know that's Mercury down here, and you know that's Venus there. So what the hell is that? So we got to keep our eyes open, okay? Because the magnetic line shows you that that's Mercury right there, okay? And as you see, we also have something out over to the left of Mercury, so you see there's three magnetical lines. You see this one here? Watch right there. So, we'll keep our eyes open. Now, anybody was up last night that just saw the action that was going on over... It's nothing today right now, anything close, but we do have actions. And things are starting... You see Australia, they're getting a little action. So, things are going to, you know, keep up and down, up and down, up and down. So, right now, there's really not much on earthquake. But last night there was, it's early in the AM that we're getting action. And Taiwan was what thick with it last night, okay? See, in the blue and the red, they always hide stuff. You don't really get to see it, okay? Because that's all you're seeing on the blue, okay? And remember, watch the mag. The mag is right here, and this line here, and then you have the depth over here, okay? And then we'll scroll through this real fast. We'll go through two pages. And as you can see, 6.1 there. And then you can always freeze the screen. And so there's plenty of action still going on out there in earthquakes. So we'll keep watching the gray shots on. So basically, we got another comet, pretty much like Lovejoy or something, or maybe bigger or smaller. And we'll keep an eye on it, and we'll see what happens. And basically, it's going to loop around the sun no matter what. So how close it comes to the Earth and the Moon, we'll see. Now, let me give you some odds real fast on what's going to be coming around on basically actual factual February 13th through the 16th, okay? And the 16th is what it should be as the closest to us, as far as we know. And let me give you the odds on it hitting Earth, okay? No matter what, all these quakes are actually happening, folks. This is actual data. Oddsmaker's line of DA14 hitting us, out of 10 chances, that's your line and that's your result, okay? Proportional integral derivatives. There's the math. You come up with it. No matter what, the 13th of February 2013, 13th through the 16th, at that distance. Only condition code 4, as you can see there, but it's sporadic. Currently, remember, it's below Earth, so that's why they're turning. So this isn't a distance, this is the odds of it hitting you on that date. Earth. Day after, day before. Close as it should get, sporadic, at 16,854 miles.